morning comes from Psalm 29. Ascribe to the Lord, you heavenly beings. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name. Worship the Lord in the splendor of his holiness. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is majestic. The Lord sits enthroned over the flood. The Lord is enthroned as king forever. The Lord gives strength to his people. The Lord blesses his people with peace. Let us pray. Holy and gracious God, we thank you for another opportunity to gather, to worship. We thank you that you have kept us to this time. And our prayer is today, O Lord, that you would abide with us yet a while longer. Have your way in us and through us today, O God, so that everything that is said and done is to your glory. Be glorified in us, O Lord. We thank you, O God, for your goodness and for your mercy and for your blessed gift of peace. And so, O Lord, we lift up our hands, our hearts, and our voices to you, worshiping you today, declaring that you are our God and we are your people. In the matchless name of Christ Jesus, our Savior, we pray, amen. Well, welcome friends, welcome church family, wherever you're joining us from. We are so pleased that you have decided to worship with us today. We know that you have a variety of choices. And so when you tune in to New Horizons Baptist Church here in Halifax, Nova Scotia, we are blessed, and we pray that you are blessed too. This week, we are coming to you from the historic Beachville Baptist Church in Halifax, and we thank Pastor Lloyd Grant and the Beachville family for allowing us to be here today. We pray that God will bless each and every one watching our AUBA churches all over the province, our friends and family, near and far. Let's worship the Lord.
Oh,
are so glad. We are blessed whenever we are able to bring a gift to the Lord. And so we encourage you today by the words that Jesus used to encourage the disciples. Give and it shall be given unto you a good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over will be poured into your lap. For with the same measure that you use, it will be measured unto you. And so we give today with generous hearts and spirits, knowing the Lord loves a cheerful giver. Let's pray. Lord God, we thank you for the opportunity to give, and we offer to you these gifts, O Lord, praying, O God, that you will bless gift and giver. We pray, O God, that you will use these gifts to the building of your kingdom, that you would multiply them, O Lord, so that they meet every need we have. We thank you that you are the provider of all, and we give just a portion back to you with hearts of gratitude. And so, O Lord, bless in the name of Christ Jesus, our Savior. Amen.
Dear God, our Heavenly Father, Father, we come this morning to worship you, to praise you, to give you all the honor and to give you all the glory. Father, you are wonderful Counselor, Almighty God, Prince of Priests, Everlasting Father. Father, you are King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And Father, we come to praise you this morning. Oh God, we just thank you for this beautiful Christmas season that we are entering. Lord, we love Christmas. We love you and we adore you, baby Jesus. Oh Father, we just thank you, God, that you sent your only begotten Son into this world, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but should have everlasting life. And Father, we claim that life this morning because we believe and we receive. God, you are worthy of our praise. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Joy to the world, for the Lord is come. And yet, Father, we are ever mindful, Lord, that there are indeed many, Father, this morning, who at this time, God, are finding it a little difficult. Lord, people are grieving, Lord. People are hurt. Your people are sad. Lord, they miss their loved ones. We pray, God, right now for the comfort of your peace, for the Holy Spirit to come upon them and comfort them. We pray, God, that you would just wrap your loving arms around each one of these families this morning, God. All across Nova Scotia, Father, in the Halifax, Dartmouth area, in the New Horizons Baptist Church community, there are people, God, who need the Lord. We lift them up to you, Father, this morning. We ask you, Father God, to touch them, to comfort them, to reassure them, that everything is going to be all right. Father, we ask you to give us more faith. God, you said if we just have the faith of a mustard seed, we can do much. Grant us faith, God, that we would trust you more, that we would trust you and we would obey you and we would see the many bountiful blessings that you have in store for your people. Father, you came into this world to save us, not to condemn us. But that through you, through your Son, we might be saved. Oh God, we ask you, God, to look down upon our family members, God. We bring our family members to you. And we ask you, dear God, in the name of Jesus, that they would know who Jesus is, to come to know him and to accept him as their Lord and Savior. Father, we ask you to be with those who are sick at this time. We ask you, God, to go into the hospitals, Lord. Go into the nursing homes, Father. Go into all of our homes, Lord, where seniors are, where the sick may be. Just be there, God. We ask you, Father God, in the name of Jesus, to bring healing and strength, if it is your will. Father, we just praise you this morning for our congregation. We ask you, God, to just wrap your arms of comfort around each one of our congregation members. We so miss one another. But God, we just praise you because of these technological things that we're able to do today, that we can worship together like this. So this morning, we just come exalting you, giving you all the honor, giving you all the praise, to worship you, to adore you, and oh God, to just say thank you, Jesus. Oh God, we love you. We ask you to give us more love for one another. Give us more understanding and patience with and for one another. Help us, God, to be more like thee. There are so many things, God, that we would need to pray for this morning. At this time, God, we just pause so that they can just lift up their loved ones to you. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. It is in the name of Jesus that we pray this morning. Amen.
The text for today comes from Matthew chapter 8, verses 23 to 27. Hear the word of the Lord. Then he got into the boat, and his disciples followed him. Suddenly, a furious storm came up on the lake so that the waves swept over the boat. But Jesus was sleeping. The disciples went and woke him, saying, "Lord, save us. We're going to drown." He replied, "You of little faith, why are you so afraid?" Then he got up and rebuked the winds and the waves, and it was completely calm. The men were amazed and asked, "What kind of man is this? Even the winds and the waves obey him." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Consider this passage and meditate with me on the thought, a little faith. A little faith. Let us pray. Lord God, now in this moment of proclamation, we invite you to open up this word to our understanding, and our hearts are ever grateful that you care enough to send us a word. We ask, oh God, that this word be planted deep in us where it can take root and bring forth fruit that will remain. We thank you, Lord God, that your truth says, when you send it, it does not return unto you void, but accomplishes the purpose for which it has been sent. And so, O Lord, do a work in us today. Use this word to edify us, O God. And I pray now, Lord, that I would decrease so that you would increase and it come forth as you would have it. In the mighty name of Christ Jesus, our Savior, amen. In this passage, Jesus is in the region of Capernaum. He has been healing some from diseases and delivering others from demon possession. He even healed Peter's mother-in-law from a fever. His fame is spreading, as evidenced by the throngs of people, numerous people coming to him and bringing others for a touch, or in the case of the centurion, just for a word. If you speak healing, then they will be healed. After many of these healing encounters, Jesus decides to cross the Sea of Galilee, and his disciples went with him. The word says that they were all in a boat together. While Jesus is asleep in the boat, it begins to be tossed and driven in a storm that suddenly arises. So we glean our first lesson. Just because you're walking with Jesus does not mean you will not find yourself in a storm. Let me say that again. Just because you're walking with Jesus does not mean you will not find yourself in a storm. One minute everything is fine, like a bright sunny day. Then the clouds roll in and everything changes. We live in Nova Scotia and we know this. There's a saying here that if you don't like the weather, just wait 10 minutes and it will change. It seems to be constantly changing despite the season. Now, even though it is called the Sea of Galilee, it is actually not the sea, it is a lake. It was and still is subject to sudden changes. It can be calm one minute and then, just like that, change and turn stormy, just like life. And when it is stormy, it can be quite tempestuous. How many of us have said, when it rains, it pours? So Jesus and the crew start out on a perfectly leisure boat ride across the lake that turns into an extreme adventure. I do not know how long the disciples held out before the panic just got to be too much, but when it did, when they could not handle it anymore, the disciples started calling to Jesus for help. Wake up, wake up. This reminds me of an old friend of mine that was so super hard to wake up. Rain could be pouring in on the window, and once it was, but she would not budge. That's how hard Jesus was sleeping. They are in a storm strong enough to frighten them into thinking they might die, but Jesus is sleeping peacefully. This story is such a sharp reflection of our walk of faith. On the one hand, you know Jesus and who he is. You witnessed his miracles. He has healed and delivered people right before your very eyes. And yet, on the other hand, you are afraid. In his very presence, church, we get afraid. When they were waking him, they called him Lord. How much more safety and security do you need when you have the Lord with you? Why would you doubt your well-being when Jesus is right there with you? If you're walking in the way that Jesus has instructed, going where he directs you to go, doing what he has commanded you to do, why do you doubt that everything will be all right? After all, the Lord was in the boat with them. Just because you are walking with the Lord, saints, does not mean you will not encounter a storm. What would your response be? The second thing to tuck into your know that you know belt is that the Lordship of Christ demands all of creation obey him. The disciples call him Lord 1 minute, and then they wonder, what manner of man is this? What kind of man is this? Their head knowledge and their heart knowledge have not made the connection. When we know Jesus, when we understand in the spirit realm that Jesus is Lord, then we must connect that belief to our heads as we navigate the challenges of this life. Avoid the temptation to do so much thinking, you forget to be doing more praying. If Jesus had been only a man, he would not have had the authority to calm the sea. Wondering what kind of man he was would have been a logical question. But because Jesus was divine, his ability, his power, his authority should not have been questioned. Marvel, wonder, but do not doubt that he is who he says he is, and he can do whatever he wills or has promised to do. What is possible for, or what is impossible for human beings is possible with God. He can do anything. And his desire is the best for you. Jesus always tells us not to be afraid. The trials we experience, the storms of this life, are not meant to shake us. They are meant to shape us. They do not come to break us. They come to make us. Jesus wanted these disciples to realize who was in the boat with them. He wanted them to know who had called them to follow him. He wanted them to know without a doubt that they can trust God in full security, in full safety, day in and day out, without a doubt, even in a storm. And lastly, our example for life should come from Jesus. The lake was subject to sudden storms, and no doubt average seamen would be steady on the watch, always trying to be prepared should a sudden storm arise. But Jesus was so secure in his trust of God and God's watch that he knew he did not have to watch. Jesus came in human flesh. And in his humanity, Jesus trusted the Father to keep him and his companions safe. Jesus slept peacefully, that is to say, full of peace. And that is what Jesus wants for our lives, that we be full of peace. Peace-filled Jesus is still a peacemaker, and he is the giver of perfect peace. Before leaving this earth, Jesus extended his peace to us in John 14, 27. He said, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give as the world gives." The world's peace is temporary and fleeting. The world's peace is circumstantial and conditional. The world's peace is not immune to the meddling of men. But Jesus gives a peace that can never be taken. It cannot be distorted. It is the assurance each believer has that Jesus is with you no matter what. When the disciples woke him, Jesus replied, "You of little faith, why are you so afraid?" One of the things that is misunderstood in this passage is Jesus is not saying that they have a little faith. Jesus is saying that they have no faith. It would be like us exclaiming to our doubtful family and friends about something we are attempting to do, "Have a little faith, will you?" Because we know a little faith can move mountains. A little faith can do miracles. If you have just a little faith, God can use it to achieve great big things that will grow your faith. So Jesus is not rebuking them for having a little faith. Jesus is admonishing them for having so little faith that it amounts to no faith. In John 14, 27, when Jesus gives us his peace, he concludes with what his disciples should have already known. "Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid." Why are you afraid? Jesus is with you. Peace. Be still. This is the second Sunday of Advent with the traditional focus on peace. During Advent, we remember the first coming of the Savior into the world, God incarnate, come in human flesh to dwell with us, Emmanuel. And we also rejoice in the knowledge that Jesus is coming back again. Advent means coming. Hallelujah, coming. Arrival. So we look forward to the Messiah's return. In the meantime, we reflect, we prepare, so we will be ready. While Jesus walked the earth, he brought many gifts to humankind. He taught us the things we need to know to think and live as kingdom citizens. He taught us how God wants us to be, the way we are to build our relationships, first with God and then with each other. He taught us how to live harmoniously together. Because of Jesus, we have the peace of knowing that no harm can come to us. Because of Jesus, we have a peace that passes all human understanding. The peace that Jesus gives is a sense of safety in the midst of a storm. You never knew it, and now you're living through it. But that is the key, church. God is bringing you through. Nothing we face in this life, no challenge, no obstacle, no attack comes to stay. It comes to pass. It will not last. The peace that Jesus gives is the assurance that whatever we face, we do not face alone. The world defines peace as the absence of war, but the peace of Christ has nothing to do with physical warfare. The peace of Christ is about spiritual warfare. It is the truth that even while the war is raging, believers have a steadfast assurance that we have Emmanuel, God with us. He is the wonderful counselor, mighty God, everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. When trouble rears its ugly head, remember you have peace because Jesus is with you. You're not alone out here. COVID-19 is defeated. Racism is defeated. Hatred is defeated. Yes, there will be challenges. You may have to go through some stuff, but the peace that Jesus gives cannot be taken away. Have a little faith, will you? When the doctor gives you a negative diagnosis, remember that the one who created you is able to heal you. Let not your heart be troubled. Be at peace. Have a little faith. When your money is a little funny and your change is strange, don't fret about it. Be at peace, remembering that all the and all the gold belongs to God. And everything God has is ours through Christ Jesus. Have a little faith. When your spouse acts like a louse and your offspring are being wild things, go to your closet and pray. Speak peace in your home, knowing that Jesus can change any heart. Have a little faith. When mess is happening on your job, or if your job has laid you off, remember that Jesus is a way maker. You can be at peace because Jesus Christ can make a way for you. Have a little faith. But the peace of Christ is not only about what we receive or what we experience, it is also about what we give. Jesus said, "Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God." Let us all endeavor to be peacemakers. It starts in each one of us. You cannot look to God for peace unless you have endeavored to be a peacemaker. Peace is not the absence of war. It is the presence of God. You are indwelled by the Holy Spirit of God so that you can bring peace wherever you go. Sometimes we wrestle with things unnecessarily. We cannot seem to find peace. Do not let the enemy rob you of your peace. Stop fretting over every little thing. There sometimes seems to be a race to see how many bridges you can cross before you reach them. How many mountains can you build from molehills? How many isolated incidents can be imagined into an annoying pattern? We wrestle with things unnecessarily. Jesus said, "My peace I give." Do not let your hearts be troubled and do not be afraid. Whatever you are facing, church, besides this pandemic and all the challenges it brings, when will you get back to work? Will your money be enough? How will you finish school? Will your children be behind in their education? Is your parent safe in the nursing home? What will your family do for Christmas? Whatever you are facing, remind yourself that you are not in this trial alone. The Lord is with you. Whatever today's storm, trust God to work it out. It only takes one word from the Lord, and He gave the word to all who would believe. Peace. Have a little faith. Amen.
Child of peace.
the table of the Lord. Come, not because you must, but because you may. Come, not declaring your righteousness, but come declaring that you are in need of a Savior. Come, desiring to be a true disciple of Jesus Christ. Come, endeavoring to follow him and to obey his commands. Come, remembering the wonderful sacrifice that he's made on your behalf. Come, because the Lord Jesus Christ himself invites you to come. The word of God tells us that on the same night that Jesus was betrayed, he took bread, he blessed it, he broke it, and he said, "This is my body given for you. This do in remembrance of me." And in the same manner that he had taken the bread, he took the cup and he said, "This is the new covenant in my blood, shed for the remission of sin and for the redemption of many. As often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you do proclaim my death until I come. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God." Let us pray. Holy and gracious Lord, we thank you for another opportunity to come around your table. We thank you, Lord God, for being able to remember the wonderful sacrifice that you made on our behalf. We thank you in this season of Christmas for the reminder that you were born to die, that you came to save us from our sin. We thank you that you became sin for us so that we could be cleansed, justified in the eyes of our Creator and made new creatures so that we might walk and talk with you and inherit the kingdom. We thank you for the wonderful sacrifice that you made, this great mystery to us, that we can be called the children of God. And so, Lord, we come around this table with hearts of thanksgiving, remembering all that you have done. And wherever people are, we ask you, Lord God, to consecrate the elements, hallelujah, as they go through this remembrance, consecrate the elements, O Lord, so that when we feed on you, our hearts will be changed, our minds will be renewed, and we would walk more humbly before you. We give you thanks for every good and perfect gift. In the matchless name of Christ Jesus, amen. Jesus took the bread, he blessed it and said, "Take, eat, this is my body given for you. Let us eat together." And in the same manner that he took the bread, he took the cup and he said, "This is the new covenant in my blood. Drink from it, all of you. Let us drink." Hallelujah. Praise be to God for his wonderful work. I pray that this week you will be blessed and you will be kept in a spirit of peace, and not just this week, but going forward, that you won't let the events of these times disturb your peace. Know that God is with you, that God keeps you, and that God will make a way.
Victory to win. There's one that's right.
Please receive the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you peace. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.